How's it going, everybody? Trainer Connor here, and it's time for a Wi-Fi battle video. And this battle is an interesting one just because we're facing off against Necro, Skivo, and the tier that we're doing today is a little bit different. We're doing the RU tier, which stands for the rarely used tier, so Pokemon that you don't normally see in battle that much, that's what we're using. So, on my side, we have a defensive Spiritomb, a Choice Banded Flygon, Mega Glalie, defensive Slowking, an offensive Drapion, and a Choice Scarf Typhlosion. On my opponent's side, he has three of the same Pokemon that I have. He has Drapion, he has Mega Glalie as his own Mega as well, and then we have Slowking as well. So, very interesting matchup here. Some threats that I have to worry about are going to be, I would probably say, because Galaxy in this match is going to be a little bit different. Normally, I would take advantage of Galaxy because it's really threatening, but it's actually a more defensive set, and you'll see what I mean when you watch this match. I'm going to say that Venusaur is his favorite Pokemon, so Venusaur is going to be a threat. Pretty much Mega Glalie is going to be a threat, and Drapion as well, because I faced Drapion before, and it's really strong. So without further ado, let's go ahead and play this thing. I'm going to open up with my defensive Spiritomb. He's going to start with Dialce, which I guess that immediately worries me because I'm weak to those fairy type moves that it's going to go for. So I'm going to switch out of here, and he is going to go with the Moonblast as expected there. So the only Pokemon that I have to switch in on Moonblast like that is going to be King, the Slowking, who takes that really well because this is a max HP, max physical defensive set. Now here I overpredicted. I was pretty sure he was going to switch into Venusaur expecting the water type move, but he goes for Stealth Rock with his Galaxy. So that's where, you know, I got confirmation that the Galaxy is a little bit different than the most I've battled before. So now he goes into his Venusaur Moker, and this particular Venusaur is gonna be an interesting one too. So here I go for Scald, and I actually get the burn. That's really good. It kind of, because if he's running Black Sludge or Leftovers, then it's going to be negated because he's burned. I wasn't sure what he's going to do, so I stayed in. And he just blasts away with the Leaf Storm. So Slowking goes down very early there. I was going to go for a Psyshock and trying to put as much damage onto the Venusaur as possible. But that's okay. I'm going to get a free switching opportunity into Glalie here. Mega Evolve and bluff the fact that I have Ice Shard. I do have it. It's just like trying to scare him. I actually go ahead and Mega Evolve here and go straight for the Crunch, expecting his own Slowking to come in, expecting the Ice type move. So that's amazing. Of course, Mega Glalie has the ability where normal type moves like Return and Giga Impact on this set in particular all are turning into Ice-type moves and get boosted power. So here he gets a critical hit, Scald, and I'm like, aw, that sucks. I was pretty sure he was going to switch, so I took that as a great opportunity to try out Return and just take out Hitmonlee without any fake out shenanigans with the unburden ability that it has. It's just a great time to go for it. So that was a great turn there. I was really sad to see that Drapion outsped me. Most mega Pokemon tend to be faster, but no, not the case here. So I'm forced to go into Flygon here. Again, he's still outspeeding me. That's a little unfortunate. I am Choice Banded, but without the item, I'm no longer not Choice Banded. So we're able to take out Drapion. Just seeing the damage it did, I figured it was more offensive orientated. So seeing that I took out Drapion like that is actually not surprising in this battle. So I'm here with Spearkin, expecting the Glalie to also go Mega and just go for an Ice Shard. He could have predicted that and just go for a Crunch for neutral damage, but the Ice type move is Stab. It's gonna be a good choice to go for. So we take that Ice Shard really well. He could go for a Return, but I didn't see that happening. I actually go with the Will-O-Wisp right here, and we actually burn Diancie, which is amazing. You don't get that many opportunities to burn a Diancie, because most of the time, Diancie goes Mega and gets the Magic Bounce ability to bounce back those status moves right back at you. So here I was expecting a Moonblast, but again, this Diancie is pulling tricks off its sleeve there, unless, you know, he goes for Heal Bell. And that kind of sucks, because the burn that I put on the Venusaur and his other Pokemon are now gone. That sucks, but I figured he was going to go for another Moonblast. So we're going to stay in again, go for another Destiny Bond. He's careful about this, so he goes for a Diamond Storm, Necro does, and I take that really well, because I'm a defensive Pokemon here. I'm like, okay, you should go with a Moonblast or something, because, like, at this point in the match, I'm just trying to make my opponent think that I'm predicting him to predict me to do this, do that, you know? It's just not working. So he goes for another Diamond Storm, which is gonna be a little unfortunate, because he gets a critical hit and he almost knocks me out there. And I say that it's unfortunate because it didn't knock me out and I went for the Destiny Bond. Ugh, very frustrating, right? Here he finally decides to switch out, and so I actually predicted him to do that. That's amazing, right? So I go for a Ping Split, and we catch Gob Smacker, the Slowking coming in. We get a lot of HP back, because Slowking is really good on the HP department. And on top of that, this Spiritomb is going to be going for a Shadow Sneak. I carry this move for priority purposes, and because Slowking is actually faster, I'm gonna go for that. We get a critical hit. I'm not sure if it mattered. It probably did, because I don't have that much attacking power invested, so I'm really grateful for that critical hit. Unfortunately, he still has his Mega Glalie, and it's too bad that I don't have a Choice Scarf or Flygon. A Choice Scarf Typhlosion is great, but you are limited to, like, because this Typhlosion has Fire Blast, or no, Flamethrower, excuse me, it has Flamethrower, Eruption, Focus Blast, and Extra Sensory. Choice Scarf Flygon would have been great against the likes of Diancie, so I say that it's really unfortunate I don't have Choice Scarf Flygon. I opted to use Choice Band just to bluff the fact that I have the Choice Scarf, but, you know, it just didn't work out too well. I'm forced to go into Drapion here. I was expecting to take that a lot better than I did, seeing that Diancie was more defensive, but Dread Scorp is not gonna take that. I thought that cross poison would be neutral, but then I realized, oh, Mega Galaxy, or just regular Galaxy for that matter, is actually going to resist the cross poison. Without it, it would have been super effective. So, I mean, with that rock typing that it has. I really should have gone to Flygon, but, you know, Flygon is at low HP that, you know, Galaxy will outspeed me. Or no, actually, I would have outspeed him. So, wow, that was dumb of me there. I go for Earthquake, and we actually take out Moker, the Venusaur, which is actually surprising without the Choice Band. But I'm not going to celebrate because Mega Glalie is here again. I need to figure out a way to take care of this thing. All he had to do was go with a hidden power or something like that to take care of my Typhlosion. That switch was way too obvious in my opinion. So, here I go for Focus Blast and miss. Of course, because it's Focus Miss and not Focus Blast. If I hit that, I really should have just... And you know what that means? This match is over because my last Pokemon is going to be Flygon. Had I went for the Fire-type move with Typhlosion, I would have to deal with Galaxy and vice versa. So it would have been Necrocebo's game either way, but that was still a great match. Thank you, Necrocebo, for a great battle. Hopefully we battle again. Best of luck in the PPL or the Pokemon Premier League. Of course, go check out Necrocebo's channel if you want to see his matches when he posts them. And stay tuned for more Wi-Fi battles and giveaways on my Twitter account, because I'm doing giveaways, shiny Pokemon with great IVs, and they're battle ready and legitimate. So stay tuned for more content, everyone. I'll see you next time. Make sure you like this video if you like this video, and subscribe. All right, have a great day, trainers.